Okie dokie, friends. I think that's my common greeting. Anyway, in this screencast, time to talk about optimization in a geometric setting. So these will be problems that are word problems that involve some geometry, and we're asking you to find the biggest this or the smallest that under those geometric parameters. And I'll show you the way our fathers did it, and their fathers before them, and their fathers before them. This is the standard example one. Farmer Brown has 120 feet of fencing. He wishes to enclose a rectangular pen of largest area, and we can talk all day long about why he might want to enclose a rectangular pen of largest area. What are the dimensions of the pen? So the first thing we do is we have some kind of picture. That picture, there are some variables that are going to go in as labels. We don't know what this dimension is. We'd like to know what this dimension is, maybe in terms of x. And fortunately for us, we have 120 feet of fencing. Well, if we have 120 feet of fencing, then these two sides have to add up to, right, 60, and so this is 60 minus x. So now for our goal. I know how to optimize. I learned a few lessons back that if I'm looking for a maximum value, that's going to occur at a critical point or an endpoint of the interval. So there has to be some kind of critical point, some kind of check for a derivative equal to zero somewhere. Derivative of what? Derivative of an area function. And in this case, the area function is length times width, and that's 60x minus x squared. If the area function is going to have a max, I'm going to look for places where the derivative is zero or does not exist. So I take the derivative. And then I want to see when that equals zero. And I think that's pretty straightforward. So now time for a little analysis. I've got my number line. That's a line with numbers on it. But really, I'm capped at both ends. X cannot physically be less than zero. Cannot be. And X cannot be any bigger than 60. I hope that makes sense. X cannot be bigger than 60. I hope that makes sense. And so 30 is a critical point between 0 and 60. We will include it. So what happens with A prime? Well, A prime between 0 and 30, A prime is a positive number between 0 and 30. A prime between 30 and 60, if I sub any number between 30 and 60 in for x in this spot, I get a negative answer. So let's use everything we've learned about calculus so far. A prime changes from positive to negative, which means that A changes from increasing to decreasing, which means this is where the max occurs. Let's answer the question, what are the dimensions of the pen? The pen is 30 feet by 30 feet, because x is 30 and 60 minus x is also 30. So we have answered the question, the dimensions of the pen with largest area are 30 by 30. Now, you're saying to yourself, duh, but it's not necessarily duh. I mean, it's just not. It's not necessarily duh. Like in this case, Farmer Brown has 120 feet of fencing. He wishes to enclose a rectangular pen. Okay, sounds familiar. But with an extra fence in the middle, presumably to keep the pinks and the blues separated. What are the dimensions of the pen? So in this case, here in x, there in x, everywhere in xx. And we've got this whole thing, maybe that's y. And so what do I know? I know I've got 120 feet of fencing. And that 120 feet of fencing is 1, 2, 3 x's and 1, 2 y's. 3x's plus 2y's is 120. So each y is 120 minus 3x divided by 2. That is like so. Now, why do I even need that? I need that because I want to know largest area, which means I need an area function. And the area of a rectangle is its length times its width. The area is 60x minus 3 halves x squared. So now what? I want the largest area. This is some function with a max, and since it's some function with a max, the derivative at that point is 0. When is a prime 0? When x is 20. And I can do a little bit of analysis. X can't be less than 0. X cannot be bigger than 40. I hope it is obvious from this why X cannot be bigger than 40. And 20 is, of course, on that interval somewhere. I can check pretty easily that A prime goes from positive to negative, which means that A goes from increasing to decreasing, which means this is where the max is. What are the dimensions of the pen? The pen is 20 feet by, let's throw a 20 in there and see what happens, 30 feet. I get a picture. I know what I have to maximize. I get an equation for what I have to maximize. I take the derivative, set it equal to 0, and solve. I hope that's okay. Here's example 3. A box is formed by cutting congruent squares out of an 8.5 by 11 piece of cardboard and folding up the sides. So we snip, 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 and then we fold, 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 fold up the sides. You get a box. Now, that whole thing's 11. That whole thing is 8.5. I want maximum volume, which means I have to have some equation with V in it. I have to have that the volume of the box is boom, boom, boom. So I've got to think. I don't know how big the squares are, so I'm going to say that the squares are all x by x. But the base of the box, this is the base of the box. So I got to know what that base is, and the area of that base, well, this part is the 11 minus two little x's, and this part is 8.5 minus two little x's. So the volume of the box is the area of the base, that's 11 minus 2x times 8.5 minus 2x, times the height. What's the height of the box going to be? It's going to be how big that square is that we cut out. So the volume is 11x minus 2x squared times 8.5 minus 2x, and I could multiply that out and get some nice cubic for volume, but I don't want to do that. I just want to take a derivative. And I can take the derivative using the product rule, right? Right? So that's 11 minus 4x times 8.5 minus 2x plus negative 2 times 11x minus 2x squared. How about that? And that turns out to be 12x squared minus 78x plus 93.5. I know that x cannot be negative. I also know that x cannot be any more than 4.25. And I hope it's obvious why x cannot be any bigger than 4.25. Here's the thing. There are two places where v prime is 0. This is one, That's the other. Which one gets rejected? Right, it's outside the interval. So we only take 1.585. It turns out that that's where V prime changes from positive to negative. And so this is where the max occurs. And so the max occurs when x is 1.585. And that'll help determine what the other dimensions are. I will not record those other dimensions because I want to keep this under 15 minutes. One more. A cylindrical can of soda is to hold 370 milliliters. That's important because those are cubic centimeters. I've got a radius and a height. I want to minimize the surface area. So how do I minimize surface area? Surface area is 2 pi r squared, one for the top, one for the bottom, plus 2 pi r times the height. And I'm all okay with that, except that height is some variable I haven't accounted for. So let's use the connections that we have. We recognize that the volume of the can is 370, and we know that the volume of a cylinder is pi r squared times the height. So we can actually solve for height. We can actually solve for height. And so surface area is 2 pi r squared plus 740 over r. So what do I want? I want least surface area. Well, if there's going to be a min, I'm looking for the place where that tangent line is flat. So S prime is 4 pi r minus 740 over r squared. I'm looking for where S prime is 0. S prime is 0 when R is about 3.891 centimeters, and that came just from graphing. So what happens? I've got my S prime chart. I know that the radius cannot be less than 0. I also know there is no upper bound for what the radius could conceivably be. We can make the radius as big as we want just by making the cylinder thinner and thinner and thinner. So I put 3.891 on my number line. It turns out by substituting and checking that that is where S prime turns from negative to positive. And if S prime changes from negative to positive, then S changes from decreasing to increasing, and that makes this a min. So the minimum surface area occurs. The minimum surface area occurs when the base radius is 3.891 and when the height is 7.781 centimeters. That's got some interesting consequences that we'll talk about when we get together. But what I wanted you to see in four very clearly laid out examples, we get a picture, we have some relationship involving variables in the picture. We have the thing that we want to maximize or minimize. We take its derivative, we set that equal to 0, and we analyze to make sure that we have in fact found the min or the max that we're looking for. If you know that much, then geometry carries you the rest of the way. You'll be able to see what's going on when we get together in class. All right. Thanks, everybody. Have a good day.